So this is video two of my joints, and we're going to go in and have a bit of a deeper look in here. So if we look in here, we see our rotation values. We have our rotate axis, which can be separate from our current rotation. And then we also have the joint orientation. Joint orientation is essentially the dirty values that are applied to these things. So if I take this guy and I were to actually zero these guys out, you'll notice that it flattens this whole thing. So my rotation, if I go ahead and just rotate this guy here, and I say modify freeze transformations on that, the values that were here have now been brought down into here. And that's basically all there is to it. I also want to correct something that I made an error on. I said segment scale compensation when we were in the tool here. Let's open up the tool. So the scale compensate I said was this. That's wrong. It's actually this guy. Is this guy right here? Scale compensate is something slightly different. So if I just go ahead, I'm going to zero that out again, just to make it easier to see. And segment scale compensation, you don't apply it to the one that you're currently scaling. You actually apply it or not to the next one down. So if I turn that off there, grab this guy and scale, you can see that it scales as we would expect. And if I turn that on, the compensation deals with that. So that's the segment scale compensation. Next, we're going to go through some of the tools that we didn't go through. So I'm just going to go ahead a bunch of joints. Just enter. And I will do a reroute skeleton, which changes the hierarchy distance. So just move this out here. You can see that the hierarchy is now going in both directions. And one of the things that I have to mention here, with that scale compensation that we had, it was basically to deal with something like this, where we have to confirm once again that there are no bones inside of Maya. Maya is not a bone-driven system, it's a joint-driven system, the pivots that are here. So we don't actually have a length value, so that scale compensate allows us to deal with that particular issue, that we don't have something called length on each of the joints. So in order to do stretchy bones and stuff like that, we use scaling rather than a calculation of length, which is what you would do in Softimage. The other thing is, when I've got something rooted like this, so if I go ahead and reparent that, press P, you'll notice that it looks like there's two separate bones. This is something that could confuse someone who's used to having these things mean actual bones in Softimage. What we're seeing right now is a single joint, a single pivot point. These things are not two separate objects. If I grab this and rotate it, the whole thing's going to move. So in order to make this not be an issue for me, I basically would have to double up on the pivots that are here. So I could do that. Just unparent this and unparent this. And I could go ahead and duplicate this guy. So just duplicate, scale the radius so that I can see it. I'm just gonna hold down control while I middle mouse button and drag just to get a better, smaller value, smaller increments. And this guy will be a child of him. And this guy will be a child of him. And now I have two angles here, and should I need a third, I can always put in a third, which will do all of them together, or I can just parent this in. So let's just do that. I'll go, let's turn off rotation, just press Q, turn that off, P, and now when I grab this one, it grabs just this one side, but when I grab this one, it grabs both sides. So that's one of the things you can do. You can, of course, also use, if features like under skeleton insert joint. So insert joint, when you're clicking on anything that has a single child, will just grab and pull out from there, and it will do the segment in between them. However, if you click on something that does not, if it has multiple children, it will basically insert an additional child automatically. And so it automatically parented it to that object, but it didn't pull out from there. So if I were to grab from this one instead, which is a child, it'll pull it out, but it'll maintain the same radius that's there. So that's basically that tool there. Just press enter to complete it. If I were to take this guy that I've created, or this guy over here, skeleton, and then remove joint, that of course removes it. This one you could just press delete, easy enough. And then we have connect joint. So let's unparent this guy and move him over. And what I needed, of course, was them to sit right over top of each other. Well, I can grab him and him, say connect joint. I need this to be a different order, so let me just do this for the moment. I'll just reroute the skeleton this way so that this is the child and this is the root. And we'll go skeleton, connect joint, and that will do that. And that's gonna mess that up. So it only connects child to that, and basically it will parent itself automatically down the chain. So that's the connect joint. And we've already looked at sort. Let's load up a proper rig here, and I will pause and be right back.